In this video, we are going to be looking at product rule. You know, product rule is one of the forms of differentiation. And you know, when you talk about differentiation, you are talking about derivative of a particular given function. You know, sometimes in a function you have multiple functions. You know, when you have this kind of question here, that you have y equals 2x raised to the power 2 times 2x minus 4. So naturally, this is a product, because mathematically, when you have a question like this, it's a product. So anytime you have a function that is a product, that is a function that one is multiplying other, you know, when you have a question like this, 1 over 2x, you can't call this one a product. This is not a product. If your y equals 1 over 2x, it's not a product. So it means you are using another formula for this, which is you are definitely use your power function for this. So it is not, because you must to understand when you have to use product rule, because no examiner will ask you that and will tell you to use product rule of this power function, or you should know yourself. So when you see a question that is a product, the function is a product, definitely you have to use product rule. And when you see a question that you have 2x minus 4 over 3x plus 2, you can see this division. And division here, it means that the first one is differentiable, and the numerator is differentiable, and the denominator is differentiable. If numerator is differentiable, denominator is differentiable, it means that you have to use quotient rule. You have to use quotient rule. But if you have a situation whereby the fraction, one of the aspect is not differentiable, maybe we have something like this. This is not differentiable, so it means you can't use product, you can't use a quotient rule for this. You rather use a power function. Now the same thing goes for the product rule. When you are dealing with product rule, when you see a function that is multiplication, or so you have something like 2x raised to the power 2 brackets, or even we have, you know, this is also a product like this, because it means that these 2x in two places, which means 2x times 2x. So you should also know that product must be used in this case. It's different from when you have 2x raised to the power minus 1. No, this one is not product, you know, it's not product, but this is a product, isn't it? So when you have a question like this, that is a product, you must know that you have to use product rule. So if you want to use product rule, the formula will become the y, the x, because u, the v, the x plus v, the u, the x. So what you just have to do now is, you just have to get your u. Just make any of the two your u. I can say this is my u, then this is my u, then the second function here is going to be my v. So I can write now that my u equals 2x squared. Then derivatives of this du will now be du dx, which is my du dx will give me that means I'm differentiating my u with respect to x. I'm differentiating my u with respect to x. So it's going to be, if I use, that means I'm going to use power function. If I use power function for this, I'm going to be having 4x. Then I can also write my v, which is 2x minus 4. 2x minus 4. What am I going to do? I'm going to take, you know, derivative of this also using power function. You know, this is constant, it's going to be 0. 4 minus 1 is going to be 0. It's not there. I'll just take derivative of this one, which is going to give me 2 if I use power function. So I'll take the v, the x equals 2. Since I have gotten this now, I can simply write my dy the x back. My dy the x will give me, what is the formula? U. I'll first write my u. What's my u? 2x squared. Mm-hmm. Then times dv dx. What is my dv dx? Check dv dx. This is dv dx, which is 2. I can just close the brackets. 2. Plus, what is next in the formula? V. What is my v? 2x minus 4. 2x minus 4. Times, because v du dx means v times du dx. U dv dx means u times dv dx. So v times du dx, my du dx, look for du dx. You know, this is my u, and this is my du dx, which is 4x. So I just close it like this, 4x. So I can just open the bracket if I like. I can open the bracket. So if I want to open the bracket, so what am I going to have? I'm going to be having here now. I'm going to just be having dy dx equals, then it means 2 times this will give me 4x squared plus 4 times 2x is going to give me 8x squared. 4 times this is minus 16x. So that's my final answer. Please subscribe and get more of our video. Thank you.